Hello all, this is Sahana, here with the topic complementary factors or complementary genes. So here, complementary factor inheritance or complementary gene inheritance are no doubt a type of non-allelic gene interaction where two or more non-allelic dominant genes are involved which interact with each other to produce a trait here. So as I said, there is involvement of two or more non-allelic genes, that two dominant genes are involved here, which interact with each other to produce a new character here. But whenever one of these genes are present, or when these genes, these dominant genes are present alone, they produce a similar phenotype. That is, for example, say these are the non-allelic genes, a pair of dominant alleles that is present. So when these two dominant genes are present together, they produce a new trait, whereas when A and B, these two are present independently, these produce a similar phenotypic effect. For example, say A can produce a fruit color red, and B can produce a fruit color red when they are present alone. That is, when A is independently present of B and B is independently present of A, then they can produce red color flower, red color fruit. But when they are present together, the fruit color can be, say, yellow. So that is how the complementary factors work, which means the action of these two independent genes are always complementary to each other. That is how the classical phenotypic ratio here becomes 9:7. That is, only two phenotypic classes are being produced here. To better understand this, an example can be studied here. That is the inheritance of flower color of Lathyrus odoratus, that is the sweet pea, which was studied by Bilson and Punnett in the year 1906. So here what happens is there are two varieties of pea plants. That is, one producing red flower while the other producing white flower. These are the two varieties of pea plants. So here the red color of the flower is due to the presence of the pigment that is called anthocyanin, which is produced from a colorless substance called chromogen under the action of an enzyme. So what is happening here? The red color of the flower is due to the presence of a pigment called anthocyanin in that particular plant. And when will this anthocyanin be produced? When there is chromogen, that is the colorless substance chromogen, is converted into a anthocyanin by the enzyme. So what happens? The chromogen cannot be converted into anthocyanin in the absence of enzyme. So for the production of red color flower, the both chromogen and the enzyme that can convert the chromogen into the anthocyanin should be present for the red color flower production. So in the absence of any of these, that is any of the chromogen or the enzyme, the red color cannot be produced. So here the first question goes like this. A dominant gene C is responsible for the production of chromogen. All right. When this gene is in recessive condition C, the enzyme cannot be produced. Similarly, another dominant gene A is responsible for the production of the enzyme which converts the chromogen into anthocyanin. When this gene is recessive, that is recessive allele A is present, the enzyme cannot be produced and thus the chromogen cannot be converted into anthocyanin. Alright, so therefore dominant gene A and C complements each other in this particular interaction. So the question goes like this. Two varieties of white flowered pea plant are crossed. That is, both the parents are white flowers, white flowered plants here. But they are of two varieties, which means they are different with their genetic constitution. The F1 generation had all red flowered plants. Alright, so this is clear. Both the parents are white, but two different varieties of white flowered plants. But the F1 generation offsprings were red flowered plants. Now, on selfing these F1 red flowered plants, both red and white flowered plants appeared in F2 generation, that too in the phenotypic ratio 9:7. Now to analyze this question, this is the one. Whenever there is the presence of dominant gene C, there is a production of white flower, because this alone produces white flower, as there is no presence of enzyme A to convert this C into A. And the same happens with the independent dominant allele A also. There is the presence of enzyme A, but there is no chromogen to get converted into the anthocyanin. But when they are present together, when the gene C that can produce the intermediate chromogen, as well as the dominant gene A that can convert the intermediate chromogen into anthocyanin, they are present together, only then the pigment is being produced, resulting in the formation of colored flower. So this is just a pathway how the process is happening. So there is a precursor. Whenever there is a presence of gene C, that is the dominant gene C, then the enzyme C is present that can convert the precursor, or the trigger the precursor to form a intermediate chromogen here. So when the chromogen is present, provided that dominant allele A is also present and can produce enzyme A, so this enzyme A can act on the chromogen and convert this intermediate colorless substance, that is chromogen, into an anthocyanin, resulting in the formation of red flower. So here, if one of this is absent, that is one of this is in recessive condition, if gene C is in recessive condition and gene A is in recessive condition, then there is no formation of anthocyanin, because there is no formation of intermediate chromogen. Though there is presence of enzyme A, there is no presence of chromogen to be converted into anthocyanin. As a result, there is no formation of red pigment and the flower remains white. The same happens with the recessive A and dominant C. So when there is a dominant C present in independent condition, that is when they are present alone, obviously the precursor can be converted, or the precursor can trigger the formation of intermediate chromogen. But remember, this chromogen is colorless substance, so the flower remain white. There is no further process of, there is no further formation of anthocyanin here, because the gene will be absent in the enzyme A will be absent in the recessive condition of A. When both of these are in recessive condition, the same thing happens here. There is no production of enzyme C that can trigger the precursor to form intermediate chromogen here, and there is no presence of enzyme A. As a result, the chromogen cannot be converted into anthocyanin. So that is what happens when both the gene are in homozygous recessive condition. Now, moving on to the cross here. The question says two varieties of white flowered pea plant were crossed. So here, what can be the genotype of these two particular parents? One white can be obtained by this particular genotype, when one of the gene is dominant and the other one is, other complementary factor is recessive. And another variety can be obtained by this dominant gene will be absent and the complementary genes will be present. So these two genotypes can give two varieties of white flowered pea plant here. So these genes, they segregate themselves into the gametes, and then these gametes fuse to form the F1 hybrid with the heterozygous genotype that is producing red color. Why red? Because both the chromogen and anthocyanin producing genes are present together here. They are complementing each other to form red flowered plant here. So these red flowered F1 hybrids were treated as F2 parents, and they were self-crossed. And at the time of gamete formation, these genes, they segregated and independently assorted into the different gametes, and these gametes were taken in on different sides of the Punnett square. And here again, the possible genotype of the progenies were filled in here. So here there's only two phenotypic classes will be obtained. All right. So whenever or wherever there is presence of at least one copy of both the dominant alleles are present, then there is production of chromogen as well as the anthocyanin. So that is how the flower will be red. So wherever there is the presence of at least one copy of dominant allele, both the dominant alleles, red color flower will be produced in the progeny. And whenever one of the dominant allele is being produced, then the flower remains white, because here in this case only the chromogen is being present, which is a colorless substance, and there is no enzyme A to convert this colorless chromogen into the anthocyanin. As a result, the flower remains white. This case also the same. Here there is no intermediate chromogen that can be converted or that acts as substrate for the enzyme A to get converted into the anthocyanin. As a result, the flower remains white. So that is how the F2 phenotypic ratio is 9:7 with the only two phenotypic classes, that is red is to white. That is nine out of the 16 offsprings were red and seven out of 16 offsprings were white. So this is a classical example of complementary gene interaction. So we'll be back with another concept.